and style, and I'm bringing you today's Diva Dish. Now, if you're like me, you love Mexican food, but hate all the calories. Well, today, I'm bringing you the best of both worlds. We'll be preparing a tasty barbecue chicken quesadilla that's high in protein, high in fiber, but low in calories. Wait a minute, did you hear that? That was my stomach growling just thinking about it. So let's go ahead and head over to the kitchen and get started. Here's what you're gonna need. Washed all your food, wash your utensils and your hands, then we're gonna head on into the kitchen. Now the first thing we're gonna do is cut up the chicken. You're gonna get some chicken breast, or you can get chicken tenders, whichever one works best for you. And we're just gonna slice it up. And you want it to be fairly small, because you don't want huge chunks in there. So we're just slicing it up nicely. And depends on how many you're cooking, how many different pieces of chicken that you want to cut up. But this is looking pretty good. So once we have the chicken all cut up, we want to go ahead and let the pan start getting hot. So we're going to turn this on to medium heat here. And spray it with some oil. I like using olive oil, but you can use whatever you like. And then we're gonna go ahead and let that heat up. While we're letting that heat up, we're gonna cook some of our other fillings that are gonna go in it. We've got some red and green peppers, and we also have some onions. So we're gonna just slice those up. And it depends on what kind of flavor you like. You can add some extra vegetables to this. If you like black beans, corn, that kind of thing, feel free to go ahead and throw that in, give it the flavor that you want. Now, you don't want to get too happy adding extra fillings, because then you're going to change the calories. Don't add any guacamole or sour cream. That stuff is pretty fattening, so it'll add extra calories that we're not looking for. Right. So we've got the green pepper all chopped up, and now we're going to chop up the red one. I just love the way they smell. Nice and spicy. Gives that chicken a nice, good flavor. All right. Then we're going to move on to our onions. Cut those up, mince them up a little bit. And then I think you probably noticed that I have some lime on the plate. I like the flavor that lime gives the chicken. So that's up to you. You don't have to add it, but I like the little flavor that it gives it. So we're going to go ahead and add some of this chicken in here. Let that start cooking. Alright. Add some of our peppers in there. Get that flavor going. The red peppers as well. And like I said, whatever else you would want to add at this time, you know, feel free to put it in, long as it's veggies. I think you can't go wrong with the veggies. Peas, beans, that kind of thing. So we got that sauteing. We're gonna add some pepper. And some seasoning salt. So whatever is your favorite brand, whatever seasoning you like, go ahead and do that. And we're gonna just stir that a little bit, let that get the flavor, and let that cook. All right, and we're gonna squeeze a little lime on it. Like I said, I like the lime flavor. It's nice, get the juice in there. Squeeze it, got it coming out. Barbecue sauce. So you only need 2 teaspoons of barbecue sauce. And you see this one's getting down to the end, but we're in a recession, I use every last drop. So here's 1 tablespoon. Drop that in there. And then we got one more. All right, drop that in there. Now next, we're gonna put some cream cheese in there, a Swiss creamy cheese. It's light and low fat. So we only need 1 wedge. It comes with a wedge of 8. We're gonna drop that in there and just stir that up. So you just wanna get a nice good mixture going with that. And this is gonna help everything congeal together. Back and stir that some more, but let's check on our chicken and see how it's doing. It's browning nicely. So just gonna flip it. There we go. So we want it to be done on all sides. And it is smelling delicious. And the rest of our chicken cook, we're gonna go ahead and turn on our second pan, which is gonna be for our tortilla. So turn this on to a medium as well. Spray it again. And then you're gonna take your tortilla. Now this is a wheat tortilla, very important. Take that, you're gonna place it in the pan. So we're going to let that go ahead and be simmering and cooking. Alright, we're going to finish stirring up our barbecue sauce. And then in a second here, we're going to be ready to add everything together. Alright, this is looking good. So while we have the tortilla on there simmering, we're going to go ahead and add our first layer of cheese. Now you don't want to do too much with the cheese, you just want to do a pinch. The shredded cheese, you're going to put it on one side, lightly lace it on one side, because that's where our chicken's going to go. Okay. Smells like our chicken is done over there. So let's go ahead, take our chicken and put it on over here. Just adding it to one side. Make sure you get all your veggies too, because that's the best part. You leave the edges clear because you are going to have to seal it over. So we're going to turn this off. And let that cool down. So now we are ready to go ahead and add our barbecue paste. I'm going to add a little more barbecue sauce to it because I want the consistency to be a little bit better. I've been stirring, but I'm just stirring my hand. Don't have a mixer here. So we're gonna add a little bit more barbecue sauce. There we go. And stir it up some. There we go. And you can do it however you like. You might like yours a little thinner, might like it thick, however you like it. Just don't go crazy on the barbecue sauce. So we got the paste here looking good. We're going to add that onto it. All good together. We're gonna let it sit like this for a few minutes and then we're gonna flip it and hopefully everything will stay inside. But the great thing about this, you can see it doesn't take much time to fix and it's only 300 calories. It's actually 270 calories. So it'll actually give you room to do something else with this if you want a side salad, if you would like to have a couple of, you know, tortilla chips or sun chips, something else with this, a great piece of fruit or a nice smoothie would help set this meal off great. So let's flip it, cross our fingers that everything's gonna stay together. I'm gonna be very careful with this. We did it! All right. So we're gonna let this cook on this side, and then all you have to do is let it cool down for about 2 minutes and you'll be ready to enjoy. Now, here's the moment of truth. Delicious. Okay, guys, go away because I'm about to pig out now.
Tell us what you thought of today's Diva Dish on Diva Life and Style on Facebook and Twitter. And make sure you go and subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/Diva Life and Style.